stolen, as most people go in this house and steal stuff these days.
Hi, I'm Steven, welcome to CTV, and it's an A-log. Yeah, I know it's an A-log, I know most people are like, Stevie T, we like your V-logs because you like to see your pretty little face. Well, I decided to do an A-log this time, and plus I don't usually do A-logs normally, I just tend to do V-logs more. But the reason why I've done an A-log is because I haven't done an A-log in a while, and it's like, since February 2009, since I did my last A-log, A-log 9. Now this is A-log 10, and let's proceed with the A-log. Sorry to say that I'm not doing a V-log. Alright, ranting on, let's begin. Basically, I want to discuss some topics that saves me doing a V-log and all that, and plus, I want to explain again why I'm not particularly doing much videos lately. Anyways, let's discuss with some topics. Now, the first topic I want to discuss is iPhone 4. Now, I've been saying this a couple of times in my V-logs, and I am definitely getting an iPhone 4. But this is just what happens a couple of days ago. Basically, Orange rung me up a couple of days ago saying, oh, Steven, person that wanted an iPhone 4, we got some stocks in. And basically, they got some stocks in. I'm like, yes, stocks, mom, we need to get some money out of my isolation account, let's get an iPhone 4. And then, just today, this is just today, basically, we went to go and get my iPhone 4, we took some money out of my isolation account. And then, I was particularly worried about stocks and all that, because even though it was just a day before, they run just to say they got stocks. So went into Orange, got my money out of my isolation account, so pumped up, very excited and all that. You know, I'm mostly excited and I love being excitable for a new technology, and it's going to be one of those technologies that I'll be using a lot and stuff, and I can't wait. So basically, we've got to go to the Orange shop, and basically, when we got to the Orange shop, they said, we are out of stock on pay-as-you-go. I'm like, what the hell? Because I said specifically, like you guys... You guys at Orange run my phone saying that you got stocks. Well, particularly we got... But this is what Orange said. Particularly we only got stocks in and contract. I'm like, what? And I just feel like I've been punked for some reason. I'm like, what the hell? You only got stocks for contract? And then I was like... sort of thing. Because once when I get too hyped up for something and then something horribly goes wrong, shit hits the fan sort of thing, I see some surprisingly go a bit peed off. So I was a bit peed off, and my mum was like, because my mum understands my Asperger syndrome when something happens and I get peed off really, really easily over little tiny things. And basically it's like, Stephen, are you okay? It's like, I'm fine, Mum. And basically it's like, are you sure? I can always treat you to a game or something that you got your eye on, game-wise and all that. It's like, I'm okay, Mum. I just want to go home. I was like, I understand. And basically, it's just like my mum is so sweet, though, because she understands my problems. And when I get peed off, I know I get peed off, and I trash nearly anything that I lay my hands on and all that. And I'm just pleased, though, Mum, that my mum understands my feelings. And she always keeps me happy by saying something nice, like, oh, let's get you something nice and cheer you up. It's like, no. Because as you may know, guys, that I'm trying to currently save up for the big games that are coming out for the rest of the year and, you know, all that. And I said to Mum, I'm sorry, Mum, and you're lovely and sweet, though. It's just save that money for the isolation, run the isolation account, and just save it until they get pay as you go and stuff. So yeah, I was a bit peed off and stuff like that. It was just, whoa. You know, I just had a bit of a shock day. I know most of yous have shocking bits like, oh, sorry, we are out of stock of this and that, and you know, it's one of them things that happens, and I understand it. It's just for me, though, I get easily ticked off because of my Asperger syndrome and yada 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 and all that. All right, enough about iPhone 4 and Orange and being punked. All right, I'll let you guys know in forums, you know, on Facebook and Twitter like I normally do, which I did today, saying about, yeah, and all that. So I'll let you know next time on Facebook and Twitter when I am actually gonna get an iPhone 4. Just, oh, I'm so excited and all that. It's just ridiculous. Right, next topic is Modern Warfare 2 subscription thing. Now, I know most people are going to say, like, I've been getting this on Facebook, saying it's not going to be payable, it is going to be payable, it isn't. But basically, there was a leaked thing that someone captured during the main menu, and there was a thing where it popped up saying, oh, didn't you know that we're going to be doing membership feeds for Modern Warfare 2? It's like, what? Well, Basically, for some reason, there was like some kind of subscription fee for playing Modern Warfare 2. It's basically pay to play sort of thing. I'm like, what? Really? And once I heard about this, I'm like, ha ha ha, total fail. This is what you get for doing too many blooming Call of Duty videos on YouTube and stuff like that. No offense to all you Call of Duty YouTubers out there, like say for example, Carly. I mostly watch her because, not saying she's a girl and all, but she, you know, she does some really cool Call of Duty videos and plus some vlogs and other types of random. Yeah, enough about, sorry, a bit of a shout out there, Carly and all that. And basically, yeah, it's just the monthly subscription, monthly? I mean, well, subscription feed. I'm like, ha ha ha, fail, this is what you get for doing too many Call of Duty videos and doing loads of stuff on themacinema.com. Alright, and now I'm ranting too much about Modern Warfare, but you know, I'm just sick of Modern Warfare in gender, as you may know, guys, by my recent history of videos that once it gone kaplump with the whole, you know, videos on YouTube, overrated and stuff like that, and stuff from the community with, you know, your own commandos and YouTubers on Modern Warfare 2 and yada yada yada, the most, you know, overrated games and stuff like that. Alright, I'm ranting over Modern Warfare 2 again. Yeah, it's just that, yeah, the monthly subscription fee. This is why I play Battlefield Bad Company 2. Even though that EA are deciding to do something like a monthly, well, a subscription fee for playing online, they're doing the same sort of thing as well. But they're not doing it until, like, next year or the year after that. But they're working on something like sports games, doing subscription fees and stuff like that. So, yeah, I'm not too worried about Battlefield Bad Company 2 doing subscription and all that. I would do, but it sounds stupid, though. Paying to play for a game that is really overpopulated and stuff. Now, speaking about Battlefield Bad Company 2, and as you can see by the photo, yes, that is Neon Gamespark. Now, Neon Gamespark is a popular YouTuber, and I don't normally talk about popular YouTubers on my channel, because not saying they're overrated, it's just that it's just that they get loads of publicity, and sometimes I can be a jealous, but what can you do, it's what they do. And basically, Neon Gamespark, I don't usually talk to him, and he loves my videos in gender and stuff like that, and I don't usually talk to him on Xbox Live or PlayStation Network or any sort of connectivity and stuff like that. But I love his vlogs in gender because his vlogs are awesome, because mainly he does vlogs and rants and yada 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 and stuff like that. And he's a really good popular YouTuber. He's got nearly over 10,000 subscribers. I just want to congratulate you on that. Big applause there. But yeah, it's just basically I want to talk to him in my A-log, because basically I've been having a couple of matches with him on Battlefield Bad Company 2. It was so awesome playing with him, because I don't usually talk to popular YouTubers. Normally I talk to Defy, which is, you know, Defy, Searchman X, and Space Godzilla, and, you know, and all that type of stuff that I normally talk to on Xbox Live. But, you know, it's nice to talk to Neon Gamespark. We talked about YouTubes, we talk about games in general, we had a bit of rants on a couple of topics. It was so much fun, and basically we've been, like, discussing about stuff, and we've been playing Battlefield Bad Company 2, that's the main thing, Battlefield Bad Company 2. It's quite funny, though, because it was funny in a couple of matches, because I've been stealing his kills. It's like, oh man, Stevie T, you're actually good, you're actually top of the leaderboard, am I? And it was quite funny, and I was actually top of the leaderboard on the scoreboard, and then I became second and all that, and it was quite funny, though, and I've been stealing his kills. It's like, he must have thought that I was really good on Battlefield Bad Company 2, even though it took me, like, about, like, 5 months to get up to rank, 24 I'm up to now. It took me a couple of months to get up to rank 24, because I haven't been playing it much, but it's my most played game since after when I left playing Modern Warfare 2. Anyways, enough about that. So, I enjoyed playing with Neon Gamespark. I just thought I'd do a kind of a shout-out sort of thing-ish, even though he has got, like, over 10,000, nearly 10,000 subscribers that mostly are Naruto's, because he's mostly popular because of his him talking about Naruto, and most of the Naruto's on YouTube, as he always says, basically are because of this, you know, Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 2 and stuff like that. So, yeah, a bit of a shout-out and all that, and yeah, Neon Gamespark, I enjoy playing with you, man. Maybe again sometime when I'm on Xbox Live or something. Well, judging by the screen I'm looking now on my Xbox dashboard, you are playing Battlefield Bad Company 2 because you're concentrating on the single-player mode. Alright, over topic on that. Anyways, I want to quickly talk about this new bundle for Kinect and stuff like that, well, quite quickly. Basically, they're doing this Kinect bundle, which is an Xbox 360 Slim 4GB model that's going to be... what's the information? Let me just get the information quite quickly. Right, right, they're doing the Kinect sensor bar priced at, for the US, for $150, and it will be bundled with Kinect Adventures. Also, there'll be a Xbox 360 Slim 4GB model, like I said before, in the US priced at $200, and there'll be a bundle soon with Kinect, price with Kinect Adventures for $300. So that's going to be awesome. So most people that would like to try Xbox 360 has a chance with the 4GB model. So yeah, I just want to quickly, quick mention about that. And I also want to quickly say I'm not going to be doing much videos this week, but hopefully I might do a couple of videos depending on what's on Xbox Live and PSN. So anyways, do check out my Facebook and Twitter and stuff like that. Anyways, Bergo, now see you from CT Films.